Hi, good morning students. We have completed the two lessons, the first lesson of food. And its constituents are what food is, where does it come from? The second lesson is constituents of food. I hope you completed the notes and revised those two lessons. Now come to the third lesson, that is fiber to fabric. See, in order to understand, they had given some small this one. So what it is, explains or what it says is Pelle and Bojo, the two students in the school, they won the science quiz competition in college. Alright? They got the first prize. So by that they got some money. So they were excited and they decided to buy something to their parents. What they did? They decided to buy a cloth. So as a result of that, they had gone to one shop. So after visiting by seeing the wide varieties of clothes, that is sari, skirt, sandali, dhotis, shirtis, panties and other ready-made materials, by seeing those, they would have. And the shopkeeper, explained the different clothes of different types of clothes. Some of them are made out of clothes made out of cotton, some made up of wool, and some synthetic clothes. Now come to this. So what are they decide? What they decide? So they decided to buy a sari for mommy and one of their fathers for their father. So accordingly, they bought those. So after that, coming back to home, they got excited to find out what these clothes are made of. So now, in order to do that, one activity is given. So what you do? Okay. First activity is this one. Present here by trialing in shop, then you collect some waste cut pieces of clothes. So just you touch those, so you can feel different color clothes are different fabric. Alright, so as the result of that, you will get more curiosity. Right, next. Another activity. What is that means? Take out one cotton cloth or piece of cloth. So you try to take out one arm or strand from a cotton cloth. Okay. So they had given you some small picture in order to do so. Okay. Just what you do? Just imagine this is a small piece of cloth. Try to take out a thread from it. Alright? One pair. So after that, now take out this arm, okay, place it on the table, okay, then scratch this with the help of your nail. This is third activity I'm explaining you. Alright. After that, what you will observe, okay, you can observe that it is made out of a thin air, that is a strand, thin strand. Okay, now you can observe this strand is made out of furthermore thin furthermore thin air, or else furthermore thin strand. You can observe this when you thread a needle also. So in order to thread a needle, you might have tried this one. Okay, at the end you can see some more strands. The cloth or the yarn made out of this thin kind of strands called as fiber. What is fiber? A cloth which is made out of, yarn which is made out of thin strand like things, okay, thin strands These strands are nothing but fibers. See, these fibers, when it is arranged compactly, you will get what is called as clothes. There are various types of machines in order to do so. Okay, so now come to this one. These fibers are obtained from the different substances. So we will obtain from mainly from plants and animals. Okay, they are called as natural fibers. For example, cotton, jute, silk, wool are called as natural fibers. Why? Means we obtain these from the plants and animals. Jute as well as cotton obtained from the plants, whereas silk and woolen obtained from animals. Okay, so now you might have seen how the silk is obtained. Okay, it is obtained from the silkworms, cocoon silkworms. We will obtain what is called as silk. Okay, you might have seen the cotton plants, right? Jute. And now come to this one. What is that? Another one. It is woolen. It is obtained from the fleece of goat or a sheep or yak or even from camels also. Okay, all these are called as natural fibers. So these natural fibers were sufficient in order to get clothes from Arminius backside. So later onwards, as the population going on increased, as a result of that, we need to depend on other alternative sources also. As a result of that, the chemicals that are obtained from the plants and animals, it is possible to synthesize artificially the clothes. They are called as artificial fibers, are called as synthetic fibers. Okay, so example for those: nylon, polyester, acrylic, etc. These are called as synthetic fibers. So in today's class, to sum up, what are fibers and how clothes are obtained, what are the synthetic fibers and what are natural fibers. Okay, and that activity, the three different activities, you can try out by yourself at home also by taking different types of small pieces of waste cloth. Cut those into a rectangular or a square shape. Try to take out the thread or yarn from it and find out whether it is synthetic or natural one. Will you do that one? Okay. And now with that, you read the lesson repeatedly for one or two times. As a result of that, you will be able to understand more about this and you will get more curiosity. I hope you are going to do so. All the best. Thank you. We will see the next one next class.